let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder. My motivation behind teaching is just seeing children learn and grow throughout the year. In pre-K, they make big changes from the beginning to the end. And so my biggest motivation is just seeing the children learn and grow. I feel successful in the classroom when the kids are excited about learning and they're anxious and they want to learn more and they have smiles on their faces. And even when they come back to me in kindergarten and if they remember something special about me or what we did, that's what makes me feel good in the classroom. Well, teaching pre-K, I feel like most days there's several things that don't go as I have planned. And I think in pre-K especially, it's important for me to be flexible and to move with the kids and go with where they're learning. No one probably knows that initially when I started out in college that I was pre-med and then took a turn and decided to be a teacher. And so here I am. Well, in pre-K, I laugh a lot, just the little things they say, but I get lots of taps all over me, and it always makes me laugh when they come up behind me and just tap on me. And, you know, in a normal job, if someone came and tapped on your bottom, you would be, oh my goodness, but at school, it's normal. It's just, oh, it's another kid that needs my attention.
Tell me my teacher of the year.
Because Mrs. Weiss is so nice.
Jonas Weiss, the teacher of the year.
Play it with cards and everything. Watching funny show there.
Okay.
As a principal of Cotterill, Desi Rice has done an amazing job baking cookies. Every so often I just have to ask for some cookies and she helps me out every time. She has boys. Children make you realize how hard teaching can be. It makes you appreciate your children and also the children you're teaching. Just a
young gun with a quick fuse. My motivation with teaching is after doing it for 10 years and seeing those students that you had previous years still coming up to me at Walmart or in town at the grocery store somewhere and saying, I still remember being in your class. And I remember when we did this or when we did that, and I love hearing those memories that they remember that I sometimes forget. Most people probably don't know about me other than like friends and close friends and family would be, people kind of assume with me being little that my everything in my house is little. I probably have small countertops and a stove. It's nothing like that. Everything that is in your house in the top shelf is probably in my house on the top shelf. There's things that I might do, like if we're working on the word can, and you know, you see some kids getting it and some maybe not because the C is throwing them off because the C and the K say ka. I might throw the K out there and put K-A-N and then walk off and then they're like, wait, that's not right. And so that's fun for them to see that I made a mistake, even though I know I made the mistake. But it's fun for them to see that teachers also make mistakes. So we have fun with it in my classroom. We want more parents to get involved. We have to get more involved. And we have to stick our neck out a little bit more.
That I love her. She found jokes on candy. And that made me laugh so hard. I would tell her, you look beautiful, we love you, and give her a Christmas hug. Goldman Simpson, teacher of the year. And I love her and she's really nice. Goldman Simpson, teacher of the year.
She asks our teachers to speak with their students about how tall she is. She wants everyone to feel comfortable with her. About the first week to 2 weeks, students may have some questions, but after that, they realize she's an amazing teacher, an amazing person. Ms. Simpson does our morning duty. And she's up in the gym with the students. And many times I've walked in there and I'm looking for Miss Henson and Miss Jensen. Well, Miss Henson, lots of times she'll realize who I'm looking for. She'll raise her hand and scream, here I am, Graham. I was uptight, wanna let
loose. I was dreaming a bigger thing. Seeing kids light up and find something that they didn't know how to do, and all of a sudden they do know how to do, just motivates me to keep gives me joy to know that you can reach someone that didn't know how to read, learn how to read. You can see that they only knew 5 sight words and now they know 10 sight words. I'm a firm believer that every kid can learn. They just learn in different ways. What motivates me most is when the kids come and smile. We have a pet guinea pig, and I have a particular child that it's a reward for him. And it motivates me just to have different things and be able to use different avenues in the library than what they get in their classroom to see that it changes their behaviors. It motivates them to come to school. So it motivates me to try to do better for those kids. Going on mission trips, because we've gone to Mexico and I've gone to Peru, and all of the cuts that we see in America, it's not good and it's bad. But when you go see what they're going through and what they see, it makes American education just mean that much more to you.
We get to be on the iPads on Wednesdays. She reads funny books.
How to work a lot more work and read more reading. She made me laugh because she read a funny book. It is about a monster. So we know all of our letters, and now we go to first grade. And then we're learning so much, we're going to go to second grade.
Getting on the iPad teaches me how to read.
When I think about Mrs. Creed and what makes her part of our staff, it would have to be her willingness to jump in and help with anything that she's asked to do. She will be the PE teacher if she has to be the PE teacher. She'll be a classroom teacher if she has to do that. This morning, I saw her with a mop in her hands cleaning up a mess on the cafeteria floor. The kids love her. They know that they can go to her with anything that they need. And this year, she has added a rather large guinea pig to the library. She knows I don't like rodents, but I allow her to have Guinea in there as a pet, and the kids love him.
I had a really exciting childhood. In first grade, I wanted to be in ballet. And all by the time I decided that, they were all full. And so my aunt took me roller skating, and that began a really big part of my life. I roller skated from my first grade through the junior year in high school, and then I turned professional. This took me all over the country. In seventh grade, we got a phone call right before a football game, and it was so exciting. I was going to get to try out to be a partner with one of the top roller skaters in the nation. And so my family agreed, and we drove to Wichita, Kansas. Both of the coaches decided that it was a good pair, and so that began my journey in very competitive roller skating as a dance team. 2 years later, we won the national championships in Fort Worth, Texas. That led to, when I went to college, I decided that I wanted to be a teacher because I started teaching roller skating.
Well, she's really nice, and she's thoughtful, and she's super sweet. She teaches us to be the best kid we can ever be, and she wants us to, like, really embrace what we're going to be when we grow up. I would tell her that she's the best teacher that I could possibly have in second grade.
When Miss Only messes up a word, she does bloop, and that's really funny to me. Miss Only, you're the best teacher I ever had in second grade. Be Teacher of the Year, Miss Only. She's the best teacher I ever had.
The one thing that most people may not know about Sandy Only is that she's a published author. Sandy is a very calm, always calm, caring, compassionate teacher that focuses on the family and the whole child. Her students at the end of the year, their growth is tremendous, and it's because of the dedication.
What makes me feel successful is when I see it, when I have a kid that comes in the first of the year, and I had one this year, he came in and said, "I'm a bad kid. I was in trouble all last year. I was in ISS all last year. I'm just bad." He's one of my best kids right now because that very first day I said, "Well, no, this is third grade. You're not a bad kid in third grade." And it took him a while. It wasn't that day, but he is now a leader in my class because I just didn't accept that he was a bad kid. He took a while to warm up to that, but I'm pretty proud of it now. So the one thing probably nobody else could say is the way I met my husband. I was in college. I lived off campus in a house. There was 4 girls. And we didn't know it, but we had a garage in our alley. We didn't know we were girls. And we kept getting mail for these two boys. So we kept thinking, maybe it's who lived here before. We don't know. We kept it. And so one night, these two boys rang the doorbell and said, do you have any mail for these people? And we said, yeah, do y'all know them? And they said, yeah, we're them. We live in your garage. We didn't know we had people living in our garage, and I married one. So probably nobody could say that.
She's the best teacher. She just teaches really great things.
She's the best teacher ever. You rock, Miss Delaney.
She makes me smile.
Yes, go, Miss Delaney.
I would tell her that if I had to choose any teacher in the world, she would be the one.
Everyone, vote for Miss Delaney because she's the most awesome teacher ever!
The best thing about Joni Delaney is her eclectic dress style. Can't wait to see what Joni's wearing. And she takes that eclectic style back into her classroom and her teaching. Her kids absolutely love her. She is passionate, empathetic, nurturing in her job and what she does. And I've often said in my years of education that I've met a lot of teachers that can teach the average child and with the average home life very well, but Joni can teach the below average child, and not very many teachers can do that.
I think my number one highlight in teaching is when I have students who come back and remember that moment when they got something, or they come to me and they say, maybe I didn't love English, but I loved your class and I realized why it was important and appreciated how you took the time to make a connection with me as a person, not just a student. My motivation is to make a difference in any way that I can. Of course, I'd love to have them excel in the subject area I teach, but I want those kids to know that someone cares. Every day, I remind myself I may be the first person to speak to them, to smile at them. They're just like the jelly beans, the gourmet jelly beans, one at a time. They taste themselves, and sometimes they get mixed up with others and it's not real great, and other times they're all together and it's wonderful. It just, you have to look at the situation individually. I don't have just one mentor, because I feel like I learned something from everybody. The principals with their support, other teachers, everybody has their own bag of tricks, and when we share those tricks sometimes, it makes us all better. Not many people know I have two uvulas, but that's kind of weird too. Also, I was feature twirler for Oklahoma State University 1 year, and then I transferred to Arizona State, where I was feature twirler there. And I don't think a lot of people know that, because I don't talk about that much.
She helps you out whenever you need help, of course, but not me, because, you know. Today, actually, we were in class, and she said if one of us got this question right, she'd tap dance. And then my friend did, and she tap danced, and that made me crack up. Love you.
Well, one of my friends, she can do the splits, and so she was showing Miss Branson, and Miss Branson goes, I can do it too, and she does it, and it was really funny. I would say good job. You're really funny, and you're my favorite teacher so far.
Good job. I'm really proud of you, and you really deserve this.
When she applied for the position a couple of years ago, she wrote down her references, and so I called one of the references that I knew, and I said, I've got Audra Branson who's applied for, and that's as far as I could get, and the gentleman said, hire her. And she has no doubt been a blessing for Guthrie Upper Elementary School.
The number one highlight I have in teaching is when I'm out in the community and I have the opportunity to see previous students. And when I see them, I'm usually embraced with a huge hug or a big smile, or them reminding me of a special memory that they've had with me in my classroom. When I was in my undergrad, working towards figuring out what I wanted to major in, I switched multiple times before I finally decided to be a teacher. The person who influenced that decision was my father, and he was a coach and teacher as well. And so I remember we didn't get from the driveway of our house to the stop sign down the road before he had convinced me that this is what I was going to do. And since then, that's what I've been doing. So.
She made a mistake, writing down problem. We proved her wrong. And she was laughing, then we were laughing too. That way she's the best math teacher I had, and I'm glad for her to get Teacher of the Year.
She has a good personality. She's nice and kind. She teaches really well, and that she's helped me, and I hope she wins Teacher of the Year.
Because she's sweet, and she helps us do our math. She's pretty cool.
When she's with students in her classroom, and I've seen that, she puts everything to the forefront. I could come in, need to ask her a question, just a real quick in and out, and she doesn't stop. She will keep going, and she will make me wait, which is what I appreciate so many times that I like to just kind of go in and ask a question, but she won't do it. She keeps those kids and engaged at all times, whether it's through group work, whether it's through a quick lesson that she's going to have, and those kids really appreciate the way that she explains things to them, and they truly appreciate it, and I know that they love her.
Best thing that happens in the classroom for me is when you're teaching and you don't think anything's going right, and then you say it a different way and somebody gets that aha, that light bulb moment when you know it finally sunk in. Feels pretty good when the kids can come back, especially like maybe last year's students, they come back and they say, wow, you did teach me what I needed to know for fifth grade, or I did need to know how to do fractions because you were right. It was what I needed for the next year. It's very humbling to think, okay, I am doing what I need to be doing. They are learning whether I think they are or not. A few people might know it, maybe some of my long lifetime friends, but I secretly love rap music. It's a thing.
Because she's nice and she helps you learn and she's the best teacher.
She sometimes messes up and she says her words really funny when she messes up. Sometimes she'll go bleh. Because she's really nice and really caring and she loves her students. You're awesome, Miss Ross.
I think she's really, honestly, really nice. She has a fun personality.
One thing that I appreciate about Jackie Ross is just her firmness that she has with the kids. She's very fair. She has high expectations. Always go into her classroom, I see her up teaching, working with kids. She wants what's best for them. Being with fourth grade, it's a hard transition for those students, but she does it well. She eases them into it. She's very firm with her students.
I think students need to have people who understand what they're going through in their lives and the things outside the school that might impact how they learn. And I think I know enough about that through life experiences to be able to come in and maybe help coach students through the difficult days and the difficult concepts that they're having trouble learning and kind of related to what they're going through maybe outside the school a little bit more. Probably something about me that is not something I share a great deal with my coworkers for sure, and very few people around here may even know that, is that I'm the assistant fire chief of Oak Cliff Fire Department. I've been there for 20 years. I've been an EMT for about 35 years, and I've tons of certifications in emergency management. And I just think that that's an outside interest and an outside life I have that is separate from what I do in this building.
Well, I think it's mainly his personality when he's teaching. He always tries to make it fun and entertaining for us, and it's a really fun class. I want to tell him that he's a great teacher, and I like how he's teaching.
Because he gives children a learning experience with, like, robots to windmills. Thank you for helping me out this year and have a great rest of the year.
It's just like, I like building stuff and it's all around just a fun class. He's really kind to everybody and he treats you with respect. He's probably the smartest teacher I've had in my whole lifetime and the most kind-hearted.
When I think of Terry Darcy, it's change. And what I mean by that is he is one of our tech ed instructors, which we have renamed STEM. Prior to Mr. Darcy being here, kids were looking for a reason to get out of that class. And ever since Mr. Dorsey has been here and the changes that he has made with that entire program and taking the bull by the horns, kids are now begging to get into that class.
I think my number one highlight would be after I've taught something or I explain something and I have a student who just has a light bulb moment. I've got something here I want to show. So when a kid becomes, it's taken me days to explain a topic, and then all of a sudden you see that the light bulb just comes on, and I bring this over to them, and they get to hold on to the light bulb because it makes them feel very, very special, very like they've got it. And one thing I think that makes me feel successful is that I'm still doing it 17 years later. It makes me want to explain more. Or when they ask questions that stump me, that I really want to go back and find it in a book and find it in online and come back and say, here's what I know. When I don't know something, I tell them the truth. I don't know. Let me look it up. And I think that's why it kind of keeps me going, is because I'm always learning.
He's fun and he puts a new perspective on things. It's like when people fall asleep, he has a hammer and he bangs it on a desk and it wakes him up. I think that's really funny. Thank you for teaching us, because I know that there's been times where I've talked or been disruptive in class and he's given me more than one chance.
He showed us that there was a Gatling gun in the Civil War, and I never knew that. So I thought that was pretty interesting. One time we were just like talking in class and he walks in and he's like talking about why hasn't Frosty the Snowman been arrested? Because, you know, he takes kids and he stole a hat from a guy. I feel like his personality is, like, great. Like, he makes every teaching moment super easy to understand. Nothing's, like no one's ever disappointed. And it's kind of funny because he actually has his own cabinet full of Twinkies, too.
He has really long hair, and he let it down. Like, the first time we've ever seen him, like, let his hair down. He walks in class and everybody just dies laughing. I want you to know, Mr. Deering, that you're a great teacher, and just keep up the good work and do everything like you always do.
First thing that comes to mind when I think of Brian Deering is enthusiasm he brings to the classroom and the excitement for the content. We talk about that a lot in our building, that the more enthusiastic and excited you are from the content, the more the kids will be excited about the content. And it's no secret why the kids like Mr. Deering's class and like Mr. Deering, because of his fun, innovative, and exciting and enthusiastic way to teach the material.
A student comes from nothing to something, it really makes me feel whole, I guess, whenever I see that flourish, you know, throughout. And then when that happens and it spreads to other students, it really makes a difference. What makes me feel successful is again, seeing the kids succeed, having a will to succeed. Actually, I could care less if we get ones. I could care less if we end up winning state, whatever it is. I could care less. What I really care about is when the kids feel like they have done their best and they have a good product.
He's fun. He's really, really fun, but he knows when to be serious when he needs to be. I just want to thank you for everything that you've done for us, and being there for us, and not just being a teacher, but being someone we can turn to if we need something.
He's really animated, and he gets really into it. If I could say anything, it would be thank you, because I've grown so much as a musician and as a person because of band. I've learned how to be a leader.
What's most important about band, especially our class, is because us as individuals make up the strength of our ensemble, but individually, without us there, we're not as strong as what we would be. Oh, there's been many times. There's like a couple things that like he'll try to be funny and he'll completely just botch the joke and all of us are like laughing at him, but he laughs with us. And then I remember there was one time that for Christmas we were all like doing like Secret Santa gifts and someone got him a mullet. And we have this video of him playing the drums with his mullet on. He's there for us as individuals, which I really appreciate. And I just want you to know that I love you. And words cannot describe how sad it makes me to leave you my senior year.
Rob Blackburn is genuine to the core. He is in this business for kids, and what you see is what you get with Rob. He's the same always. From the first time I met him out on the blacktop, summer of 2012, he was chasing kids all over doing summer band, and he's been the same way every day that I've been around Rob.
I would just say be student-centered. We have lots of buzzwords in education, whether it is data-driven or whatever it is, but I would just say be student-driven in everything that you do. Put them first and foremost, because without them, we don't have much purpose for being here. Something about me that no one else knows is I love to write poetry. My wife has 56 poems now, so she gets one every anniversary and every Valentine's Day.
Mr. Jordan has a background of being a youth pastor, and I just think that really helps him explain things and lecture correctly, and he can really like tap into a lot of students on a personal level. Thank you, Mr. Jordan, for helping me exceed throughout the subject of English and just giving me advice on actual life and helping me in multiple areas of my life.
His class is really special because this is the first year that I have had a teacher that doesn't care about training us for a test, but actually teaching us so we understand it and are able to do it on our own without help. Mr. Jordan, thank you so much for all that you've taught me this year and not sugarcoating anything.
He speaks to the students to the point where they get it, because not everyone interprets the same thing the same way. Mr. Jordan, I just want you to know that I appreciate everything that you've said and done for me, whether it be critical on my essays or the way I am in class.
The first thing that comes to my mind when I think of Jeff is the fact that whenever I walk by his classroom, teaching is always taking place. In fact, his door is always open. Mr. Jordan is a pillar at our school, and he's a great leader, a great example, and a great mentor to our students at Guthrie High School.
Elsie Jungvar, ich habe in der Schweiz gewohnt. Ich war 10 Jahre alt und ich war da für meine Mutti's Arbeit. And basically, just what I said is that I learned German when I moved to Switzerland at the age of 11, and I moved there for my mom's job, and that's where I started to learn the language. I definitely think my motivation is just that I love working with kids, and I really enjoy being around them and helping them. I also love teaching German, so that's just a big highlight in itself. I love the language, and honestly, I love helping them learn. I actually had open heart surgery when I was born. I was 9 hours old, and I actually turned blue, and now they can actually tell if you have this issue before you're born, and they can get you, you know, fixed right as you come out and everything. But it was the middle of the night, and so I was turning blue, and they took me to Children's, so I had the surgery then.
I think she should be the one, just because she works really hard with her students, and she has a lot of patience with us when she's talking and we don't understand her and we're trying to figure out what she's saying, and sometimes it can take a while for us to get it. I would want her to know that I think she's doing a great job. She really inspires me to want to learn German. She makes me want to go to Germany and just stay there forever.
Miss Lee doesn't speak English to us like at all unless we really don't comprehend what she's saying. She's doing a great job. She is probably one of my favorite teachers that I have here at Guthrie High School.
I just love the fact that she immerses us in the German language. Nix, heute ist der erste Schultag. That means, hi Thomas, what's up?
One of the interesting things about our class is that in order to go into the class each morning or each afternoon, you have to greet her in order to get into her classroom. And I will go by and see students lined up in the hallway waiting to give her a word of the day or a phrase or a passage that they're learning in that particular language in order to enter. And I sometimes kid and laugh with the students and ask them, okay, what's the word of the day?
The motivation behind teaching is there's teachers in my family, and it's not like you can't create a teacher in a classroom. So my niche is being a teacher. It's a light bulb from them, but it's telling me that I'm doing something right in the class and giving them the power to figure it out. Even though I'm kind of guiding them a little bit, I have to like make them take their hands off the side of the pool somewhat and see if they can swim. And if they drown, then they usually pick themselves up and they go, I want to try this again. And that's the cool thing about it. But I do have a second job.
I work at the Dominion House, and I'm part-time, and I am an actual wedding/event coordinator. So basically, I'm not working with teenagers, I'm working with adults that were teenagers, and some of them are former students, and I'm getting them ready for the best day of their entire life.
She's actually like so funny and like sweet in class. Really thankful that I have her as one of my teachers, because I've always been one of those kids to get lost in science.
She is probably one of my favorite teachers because she's really funny and she has a really good personality. But usually her bird, Leo, he is always squeaking, and she's always like funny yelling at him, but not like mean. She's just like this, and she's like, no, just don't get on your phone.
If anybody was to ask me who is your favorite teacher, I would definitely say Miss Rita's. She's just like really smart, and like she's kind of like my idol. Like, I want to be like her, and I want to like be smart, and I want to go to college, and I kind of want to be like a teacher now because of her.
When I think of Michelle, I think of all the fun and exciting hands-on activities she does with her students in her classes. It's not uncommon to go into her classroom at different points of the year and they are dissecting various animals, and it's just a great way for students to have a hands-on learning experience.
Well, congratulations to the 2018 Teachers of the Year. We're super proud of you, and we're actually really honored to be able to work around you in the school environment on a daily basis to see your commitment and love and caring for the kids. Wouldn't want to work around another group of awesome teachers.
Congratulations to the 2018 Teachers of the Year. I appreciate all your hard work, your dedication to the students. Thanks for everything.
Congratulations to all of you who were selected. Good luck and keep up the good work.
Okay, today we have our weather for the day. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what's coming in. We got a big storm system coming in from the south, high 57 today, but those temperatures are gonna cool down. We'll have a chance of snow next week. See the storm system coming in. It's gonna affect us in about 4 days. So don't go to Walmart and get your bread and milk yet. You got 4 days to do it. We're only looking like we're gonna get a trace. So don't go too crazy. We're gonna be all right.
It's kind of funny because he actually has his own cabinet full of Twinkies too.
What does he do with those Twinkies? Does he share them or does he just honk them down? Does he eat them in front of you?
No.
How many do you think he honks down in a day?
Probably at least two.
People come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes aside.